Every time something happened to us, you fall apart. Every time somebody call your name, you falling apart. Baby, you got to learn to rejoice when folks start calling your name. Because if they're talking about you, it means they're thinking about you. And if they're thinking about you, it means God must be talking about you. And if God's talking about you, he probably thinking about blessing you. So instead of getting mad, baby, you ought to get glad. Say, oh, I heard my name came up. Tell somebody, oh, my name came up. See, I don't learn to rejoice. I don't want to get into that. But listen, you ought to thank God if you've been going through anything in your life, whether it's relationship, finances, your children, your health, you ought to give God praise, baby. Because God's trying to see you. When you qualify for this crown, you went in it. Yep. It didn't feel good, but you didn't leave God and you haven't left the church. So guess what? Baby, you don't qualify for a crown. Help me give God praise right there and tell your neighbor you qualify. Oh, it doesn't like being qualified. Don't put me in a place when I'm not qualified. So there's the crown, incorruptible crown. There's the crown of rejoicing. There's the crown of life, those who endure. There's the crown of righteousness. This is one of my favorites right here. This is what I preached about Tuesday at New Canaan, 1 Peter 5 and 10. I love that chapter because there is a crown of righteousness. The Bible says it's for all those who love his appearing. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost, to exegete this and break this down. It means all those who live their life knowing one day he's coming back. Oh, heavenly Holy Ghost. It's for all those who wake up every day knowing this is not the end. Paul said, if Christ be not risen from the dead, we are all men most pitiful. But how many of you know, we know that just like he left again, he's coming back again. And so every day, I plan my life like he's not coming back for another 100 years, but I live my life like he's coming back tonight. I want to have church with two of y'all. Because when you plan your life, it means that whenever he comes, you're going to be ready, but you also can function here. But when you live your life like he's coming back tomorrow, you ain't got time to be trying to sneak and see what you can get into. Oh, y'all got quiet on me, man. Rocking your rat on cock right there, but I'm telling you. Y'all got real quiet on me right there. Come on. But you got to live your life in such a way that I'm living my life just in case he come back tonight. I done got my hands clean and my heart is already pure. Somebody help me give God another praise right there.